you have so many different interesting areas of your story. Can you tell us what brought you to this specific career path and a little bit about your history in STEM?
I went to engineering school and then decided that I wanted to go on to law school. And I spent the majority of my professional career working for independent and small inventors, as well as companies on their ingenuity. And from there, I decided that I wanted to be an entrepreneur of my own and wanted to invent something of my own. And so using my engineering background, I designed and developed a lock that can be put on handbags. And like all of our bags, it comes with our unique two-digit lock right on the side that you can set for yourself any combination that you'd like. And then it just simply, the zipper pull just simply drops into the lock.
As I was coming up through my career, we had a program called the Managing Director Leadership Forum. And we have one specific for women. And so I was chosen for that program. And it was one of the most monumental things that happened in my career. I got to go down to our Washington, D.C. office for a week, and they flew in women from all across the world. So I got to make really good friends and really good contacts within the company, and they're in all different segments. So just the investment that FTI has made in my career has really encouraged me to be able to give back and help other people within FTI, other women and people of diversity.
So let's talk about, why did you get involved in health tech?
In college, I was in between my senior year and I was having some headaches and went to the doctor, and within a few hours was diagnosed with a brain tumor. And definitely it was a scary period of time in my life. Went a few months not knowing what the prognosis would be, and ultimately ended up with a very fortunate prognosis, and it's something that won't affect me in my lifetime. But it was a very scary situation, and I felt very fortunate coming out of that, and really recognized and appreciated that a lot of people don't have the same experience where they come out on the other side with it not having the impact that it had on me. And so I think that just woke me up to health in general, and I was a developer, and so really gravitated towards health tech.
I'm really proud to say I'm on the leadership team of Women of Natera. I'm one of the co-chairs this year, and Women of Natera has a mission to foster a culture of inclusion and diversity, providing a platform for networking and ongoing learning to support development of women, and it also promotes workplace equality and diversity.
In March, when I think everybody was just at that, no one knew what the rules were. Everything was changing minute by minute. And I know malpractice was something that you addressed. And I'd love for you to tell me about the initiative that you were a part of.
First thing I did was call my carrier before I went in, because I needed to make sure that I was going to be covered for liability if I start performing outside my typical role. And I spoke to the CEO of our company, the company that insures me, and he said, absolutely not. You are not insured for doing that kind of work. He put me in touch with a reporter from the Star Ledger. I had a long discussion with her. She wrote a report, and I really didn't do a whole lot. All I did was answer a few questions over the telephone, and an article was written. And then literally a day or two later, the governor announced he was granting us immunity.
So Perinatal Associates focuses on maternal fetal medicine, or perinatology, which is high-risk pregnancy. So that means if mom has a medical issue, or the fetus has a medical issue, or the pregnancy is high-risk for any reason, OBGYNs send the patients to us so that we could co-manage them throughout the difficult pregnancy.
But talk about leadership style to me. How do you lead by influence?
So I believe having the ability to build a network, a strong relationship, is the foundation to my success. I've learned that inconsistency is the fastest way to ruin relationships. It's so important to have relationships built on trust, where team members are working toward the same goal.